Hello, this is Mark from My Keys to Music. Thanks for joining me on this video. Give me a second or two to set this up because there's a little preamble that needs to happen before we jump right into a very detailed and very technical lesson on how to get this application to automatically switch programs on your Nord keyboard. So first, the application we're working with today, it's called OnSong, and it really is a mobile companion for musicians. It's the Swiss Army knife. It does all kinds of things between keeping track of the sheet music that you're playing, your set list, your lead sheet. You could even control lighting. You can control MIDI items with it. You can do all kinds of things. And it's essentially allowing you to become paperless. You don't need to bring a binder to the gig anymore. So if you're looking to sort of revolutionize yourself and you're sick and tired of being the one person that comes with all the paperwork and it's just kind of flying around in the breeze and you just kind of feel so old school and you want to get with the times, then this particular app is a good way to get started. It's called OnSong and it runs on an iPad much like this. This is the 12.1 inch and it's a perfect size for sheet music. It's a little bit on the heavy side, but they make all kinds of different iPads for all kinds of different situations. Bottom line is, it allows you to just become a better musician in terms of having a better rig, a better setup, more prepared for anything. And it's fun. It's actually fun. So I'm brand new to this world of OnSong. I have some experience with Fourscore because I bought that app a while ago, played with it, and did some technical things for it. And I actually have a video up here that you can check out doing essentially the same thing for Fourscore as we're about to do here with OnSong. So anyway, if you want to learn more about OnSong, you can go online and get that. It's onsongapp.com is where you want to hang out to check that out. And I'm sure there's countless YouTube videos of people going over the features and comparisons and all that. This video is more about something really, really technical, specifically for the Nord keyboard student. In fact, this came from a request from a student and said, Mark, is there any way you can show me how to get this connected to my Nord Stage 3, and get it so that when I switch sheet music, it automatically changes the program on the keyboard so that your set list now is in sync with your programs on your keyboard, and it makes you feel like your hair isn't blowing in the wind. It's just, you're ready to go. You're all put together and you're locked and loaded for a great performance. So that's what this video is about. With that, let's start the lesson. In this video, we look at connecting the Nord Stage 3 with the iPad, specifically to the app on the iPad called OnSong. And this is the 2022 version. It'll likely work with newer versions of OnSong. And it does require a premium subscription in order to take advantage of the MIDI capability. If you have any other version other than the premium, then this won't work. It's fine to get the solo premium if you're working as an individual. It also works with the group account. Okay, so here we are on the iPad. I've already loaded OnSong here. This is the default welcome to OnSong song. And I've got one other song programmed here as I swipe to the right, Piano Man from Billy Joel. So the goal here is to be on a particular song, and as I switch to another song, it should trigger the Nord Stage 3 to update. In other words, it'll change the program so that it's in alignment with the set list. All right, so what I'd like to do is I'm going to assume that I want to play Billy Joel with A31 Grand Imperial. Just so happens that I want to play this program with the Billy Joel song. And in order to do that, I have to know quite a few things, quite a few pieces of information. But after you learn how to do this once, you'll understand the key or the matrix of it all, and it'll all make sense. So step one is you need to make sure that MIDI is on here and that you're paying attention to the channel, and that it's willing and able to accept program changes. So to do all of that, you can go to the MIDI setting, so hold the shift button and push MIDI. And you may start here on page 1, but you'll want to go to page 2 where it shows the MIDI settings. Now incidentally, a big point of confusion is which one of these do I need to pay attention to? When it comes to receiving MIDI, or should I say, when it comes to receiving a MIDI program change, which is exactly what we're doing here in this lesson, you have to use global MIDI. It doesn't work any other way. Global MIDI is the only thing that'll accept program changes. So for argument's sake, I'm going to put this on 2, just to keep us on our toes. That'll be channel 2. And the next thing I want to do is go up another page, and the next thing you'll see is control change mode. This is the CC control changes. We don't need to worry about that for this lesson, but we do need to pay attention to the PC, which is program change. And if this was set to off, then the Nord keyboard can't accept program changes. So we need to make sure that this is receive or send and receive. It really doesn't matter. If it's set to send and receive, it means that the Nord keyboard can send changes out. If it's set to just receive, it means it'll receive those changes in. I recommend, for this example, just put it on receive. That way, when you move your program, it isn't going to set another keyboard to changing programs. It's only going to be set to receive, and in this case, it works great because we're set to receive from the iPad, and that's what we want to do. So to recap what we did, we went to the MIDI area, so Shift MIDI. Then we went to the second page and decided that we were going to use global with the channel. So pay attention to that. Then we went to the next page and went to the program change area to make sure it was set to receive. That's it on the Nord Stage 3. Now, obviously, you'll need MIDI connected. In this case, I'm using Bluetooth in and out. Okay, so back to OnSong. And let's just go here and go to the top right where that icon is. And you'll want to go to Tools, Bluetooth, and MIDI. You want to ensure that your Bluetooth is connected to OnSong. If it's not connected, obviously, you won't have any luck doing much with this. So, and if you find that you try to connect it and it says not connected, and you try again, it says not connected, I have found that if you quit out of the program altogether, like I'm showing you here, and then go back in, then attempt to connect again, you should be able to do it after you quit the program. Okay. Now that our MIDI's connected and it's configured properly on the Nord Stage 3, the next thing we need to do is add a MIDI event. So I'm going to navigate over here back to Piano Man. Now I'm going to click and hold on the title where it says Piano Man, and that should bring up a window indicating a MIDI configurator. It should say MIDI events at the top. Then at the bottom right, there's a plus sign. I'll click on the plus sign. And then you just follow this from top to bottom. Under type, you want to select program, because we are, in fact, making a program change. The channel needs to be selected, so I'm going to click the plus twice to get to channel 2. The program, I'm not ready to talk about just yet, but it is necessary to set the program. The next thing we need to do is go under Bank MSB, which stands for Most Significant Byte, and LSB stands for Least Significant Byte. In any case, you need to put the MSB to 0. If it isn't on 0, none of this will work. 0 just means that we are telling the Nord Stage 3 that we want to work with program changes, different than live mode changes or different than synth list changes. This is the main program changes, and that happens to be MSB 0. Now for the LSB, that will be either 0, 1, 2, or 3, and it depends on where in the list of programs that you want to change. So the hardest part of this lesson is understanding how to set the LSB number and the programs within. MIDI has a limitation of 128 locations, yet our Nord keyboard has 400 programs to choose from. So to calibrate that, we use the LSB number. Setting an LSB to 0 picks the first 125 programs. 0 counts as 1, so 0 through 124 is technically 125 programs to pick from. Then LSB1 would get you to the next batch of 125 programs, LSB2 gets you to the next batch, and LSB3 finishes out the group until you finally reach 400. To keep things simple on this first demonstration pass, we will keep both MSB and LSB at 0. Okay, now, the final piece of the puzzle, the program that we need to set. So, just for the sake of understanding this for the first time,
I do want it to go to Grand Imperial, but I'm going to count manually here from A11, which is the top of the list. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So Grand Imperial at A31 is 11 programs in on the list. So I'm going to come back here to the iPad and set my program to number 11. Now, the reason you see labels here, in this case, music box, is because they're giving you the default standardized MIDI list. It's actually called General MIDI, and they're just giving you those names as a courtesy if you wanted to use a general MIDI instrument. Number 11 would, in fact, be music box. But you can ignore that and just go to 11 because, in our case, it's going to be the Grand Imperial. Okay, now, before we leave this screen, we can actually test it at the bottom. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to navigate away from the Grand Imperial and then test this command and keep your eye on the stage 3. Voila. The light illuminated and the program changed, just like that. Now, does it matter where I start from? No, let me go up several programs here to B25 and test it again. Perfect. Now click Done at the top right. That sort of locks things in. And then you can click outside of this MIDI event window back to the lyrics, and that should make the window disappear. So now I'm going to navigate away from Piano Man, go to another song, and I'm also going to turn my Nord keyboard to a different program. Then I'm going to navigate back to Billy Joel as if I'm getting ready to play it, and just like that, the Grand Imperial shows up. Try that again. Move away from the song, go to A12 in this case, navigate back to Billy Joel, and Grand Imperial is there waiting for me. All right, let's do one more. I'll go here to this welcome song, and I will click in the header. Now, you don't have to do it in the header. You can do it pretty much anywhere just to bring up the MIDI window, but I'm just doing that just for the sake of having a place to click. And so you bring up the MIDI window. You click on the plus at the bottom right. You select the type. You need to pick program. You need to select the channel, channel 2 in this case. The program will be depicted on what you want to do. So let's just say I want this one to be 3 in. 1, 2, 3. Well, actually, let me throw another wrench at you. Let's just go deep on the list. So I will just make something up here. So let me just say I'm going to go to program 8. And the bank MSB is 0. That tells Nord Stage 3 I want to change a program versus changing something else. And then the LSB, I'll put 1 instead of 0. So that will get me to the 8th program
after the first 125.
Okay. And then test it. Now here we go. Watch the Nord Stage 3. There. That happens to be pipe wheel on F23. Click Done. Click outside the box. And let's switch to the Billy Joel song by swiping left. There's the Grand Imperial. I'll even fool around here and go away from the Grand Imperial just to make sure we know that this works. Go right, and we'll right back to Pipe Wheel for the Welcome to OnSong song.
For students enrolled in any of my paid Nord keyboard courses at My Keys to Music, I'll be providing a downloadable PDF with the entire matrix for all these program changes, indicating which LSB number you need so that you don't have to sort of calculate this out of thin air. For those who have an engineering mind, you can feel free to make your own Excel spreadsheet or Google Sheet on it, but it is something that's kind of time-consuming to do and plot it all out for 400 programs. Anyway, I give that as a bonus for those paying students.
Now, the technique we used here works not only for OnSong, but it works for other MIDI programs or any MIDI program that where you're trying to set the Nord Stage 3 to do something, whether it be a hardware controller or something on your iPad, or some other computer program that you need to set the Nord Stage 3. It's really simple. MSB to 0, LSB 0, 1, 2, or 3, and then pick your program accordingly based on this matrix. Don't forget the MIDI settings on the keyboard itself. It has to be a global channel that has to match. It has to be willing and able to accept program changes. And of course, your Bluetooth MIDI has to also be connected and active.